We'd like to welcome everyone to the Celebration of Life ceremony for Mr. Vernon. He was an awesome guy. Every time he came through them doors on his little scooter, he had a big old smile on his face, and he was just as friendly a guy as you'd ever want to meet. And we're going to miss him. We're going to miss him dearly. And we've got some family here today. Be sure that you... Hey, sweetie. Be sure that you meet them before you leave today. And like I said, we're going to miss him so much. And I just wanted to welcome you. Thank you for staying for this ceremony. It's going to be an awesome thing. We're all going to miss him. But I guarantee you, if you could talk to him, he would not want to change places with you. I guarantee you that because he's having a lot more fun than we are right now. I'm telling you. And praise the Lord for that, man. We all have that to look forward to. It's being with the Lord just like he is right now. And man, it's going to be exciting. And I know it's exciting for him right now to be worshiping the Lord Jesus Christ. And just want to read a scripture to you right now. It's from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, and it's verses 11 through 13. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I set aside childish ways. Now we see but a dim reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Let's go to Lord in prayer. Lord, I just thank you so much. I thank you so much for Mr. Vernon. And I thank you for the opportunity to know him and to be able to enjoy serving with him here. And Lord, we know that he's with you now. And we just thank you so much for that. And we just pray for the family, Lord. It's going to be a hard time. We're saddened when we lose a loved one, Lord, but the joy comes in knowing that they're with you. And I just thank you for that knowledge that we have today of Mr. Vern. And I just pray that you continue to be with the family and just give them strength and just keep their faith strong and just keep them pressing on. And memories are good. And it's a good thing for us to have memories. And I just pray that these memories that this family has from this point on will be so joyful in knowing that he's there with you. I just thank you so much. And I just give you the praise and the glory for everything in Jesus' name. Amen.
Somewhere I get where I'm going, on the far side of the sky. The first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, or I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. Gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. So much pain and so much dark, this world we stumble through, all these questions I can't answer, and so much work to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace.
I think that pretty much says it all. Mr. Vernon Ashlock was a special man. Thank you to Debbie McKenzie for putting that together and always doing a fantastic job, and that was awesome. You know, I think sometimes we can let, try the littlest things keep us from getting up in the morning and coming to church. You know, I stumped my toe or had a bad night's sleep or whatever. He was here all the time. And you two guys had a tremendous commitment to making sure that he was loved, he was cared for, he was here, riding the scoot. Let's see, riding the scoot, eating barbecue, hanging out with Nikita Koloff, wearing the championship belt. I was trying to figure out in that picture who you were between the two little girls. No, you were pretty easy to spot. Man, just enjoyed the family, and it's so cool reading all that you contributed and put in there about him. great man. We are going to miss his Myron said him riding around here. And he could drive that scoot. He could drive that scoot better through them doors, Gary, than a lot of these guys riding motorcycles. Barrel right on in here and get your toes out of the way. I just think, and I commend you guys for the time you gave him. And I know it was a little bit hard him being out here, but, man, I don't think he would want it any other way. And as you said, he's with Jesus now. And there's not a lot more to add to that except to share a scripture that reminds me so much about the promises of God. You know, after looking at Psalms 139 this morning and thinking about how good our God is and that the days even before you're dead, tomorrow, I think Leo said it would have been his birthday. 85. Wow, 85 years old. So he has got one heck of a birthday party going on. I know he would love for you guys to be a part of it. I'm glad you're not right now, but he's got a great party going on. Man, before he was ever even formed, though, God knew him. God had plans for him, and now God's got him home with him, where we all desire to be one day. And I think about the promises of the Lord, and we just want to encourage you guys and continue to pray for y'all and the family, and because it's nothing like missing, especially a dad, father-in-law, a loved one. Jesus shared in John chapter 14, and I don't think it could be said any better, to let not your heart be troubled. It is troubling. We were talking earlier about the pictures on the wall over there. We've lost a lot of good friends, but the cool thing is so many of those folks came to freedom, got saved. We know where they're at now. We know that we'll see them again, and that's what being here is all about. That's what investing in others' lives are about, and it's cool that you know your dad's with the Lord now. Lightning into stuff up there, maybe. When I first read that, I kept thinking, because we had the thunder and lightning the other night. Got a chuckle out of that. What's Dad ran into now? It was a cool thing. He don't need that scoot anymore. Doesn't mean he ain't running into stuff. He don't need that scoot anymore. He says, if you believe in God, believe also in me. You know, that's the promise that we hold from the cross there, that we know that there's more to our lives than just this life. There's more to come. He says, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go and prepare a place for you. So we know from Mr. Vernon, his place has been prepared. And he's claimed it. He's got his keys. He's enjoying it. And he's having a great 85th birthday as he's celebrating with Jesus. He says, I go and prepare a place for you. If I go and prepare a place for you, I'll come again and take you to be with me, that where I am, you may be also. Thomas said, Lord, how do we know this? And then the scripture we love so much around here in John 14:6, Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Man, I think it's awesome how God gives us family, an extended family, to be a part of our lives, to help us through the journey, through the good and the bad. But ultimately, at the end of the day, that we can know that we have a relationship with Christ and where we'll spend eternity with him. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And so I'm glad, just for the short time we did get to know Mr. Vernon, that we did get to know him. And I'm also glad that he's not suffering anymore, though. COPD, it's not an issue anymore. He's breathing well. He's running well. He's doing well. And I know you guys know that. And we thank you guys for your commitment and your testament to us, because you guys have been such an encouragement. Every time you would part, pull that scoot out, do everything just to get him, he'd come in, and man, just I think that's such a testament to how we're to love our parents and take care of them. Proud of you. Proud of you. Let's pray. There's no Father, a time like this, there's no words that can comfort the hearts or fill the void that I know Charlie's struggling with, and Leo and the rest of the family. And Father, today we thank you for Mr. Vernon, that we get to spend just a little time here, remember him, look at the pictures, hearing the story of his life. He was cool. Now we know, Lord, he's not suffering anymore. There's no more long evenings or hard mornings. Father, he's with you. And I just pray that when the days do seem long and difficult, that you put your arms of love around my sister, my brother, and just give him a big old squeeze. Let him know everything's good. And One day we'll be together, running the streets of gold and enjoying life everlasting. Father, we're thankful for how much you love us and how good you are. And we thank you for Mr. Vernon Ashlock. Lord, he's a testament and encouragement, and should be, to all of us, how to keep on keeping on right up to the end until you call us home. Father, thank you for the time you've given us to get together this evening. Just bless the rest of this day. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Well, that concludes the service, but if you guys would, man, come by and see the family and say hey and love on them a little bit. Amen. Amen.